Because what is healing? What is a healer? That you are. That you cannot have someone heal you. No one can heal you. So there are no healers. Now those of us who call ourselves healers, we're facilitating healing within the client. We're only holding the space, facilitating. But what are we facilitating? Now we can cleanse out the aura, we can take down negative barriers and stuff that is in the way of their complete healing. In the way of them coming to the point of forgiveness, because that's what healing is about. Healing is about self-forgiveness and forgiving others. It is about accepting and allowing. Accepting and allowing. If you do not come to this point, you cannot heal. You will never heal. You'll be with healers and psychologists and all this stuff for the rest of your life. You have to come to the point of self-forgiveness and forgiving of others, accepting and allowing. Then all the healing modalities work. And your client will be happy. They will come, they will go through the process of the healing, and then they will leave, and they will email you 10 years later, says, hey, I'm still healed, I'm still okay. That is the first thing they realized. So that is the first part of what is called the King Salomon Healing Modalities. King Salomon Healing Modalities, which spans everything. The second thing they realized was that healing had to be on all different levels, on all the levels of humans, not just physical, but emotional, astral, auric, soul, and spirit. We had to go into all levels of. Even healing the connection between you and God, the connection between you and God, the divine spark between you, is sometimes injured and can be healed. It can be brought back to balance, and which is more of an esoteric healing. But Solomon, and there, that's where Solomon came. Solomon was not a shaman. He was not a medicine man. And he brought most of the tribes brought their medicine people. So our tradition, actually, shamanic tradition, is very shamanic. And we study shamanism as part of our tradition, but also very esoteric, because Solomon was esoteric. Solomon's more the bookworm, and reading and studying the magical text and the words. And there's very powerful Enochian tonings in the King Solomon healing modality, where you actually use holy words to tone into the aura, to vibrate certain vibrations to create healing. So they created these systems, this system of healing. And again, it was tested and tried all over the planet. We call it the University of King Solomon, but I'm not sure we can use that word. We're still dealing with the legal issues of that. It's, you what?
Copyright.
Yeah, well, university, you have to have a certain... Anyway, the lawyers are dealing with it, but we want to call it the University of King Solomon, because the teachings are so profound and deep. And it takes a few years, actually, to finish that. So it is like a university. So that's like a school within the school, basically. Solomon also, one of the departments of Solomon, one of the parts that he had some of these people create, so we had the teachings, we had the healings, but there was also this alchemical laboratory, boiling things constantly for those 34 plus years, whatever it was. And the alchemists that were cooking in this laboratory, they were working on medicine. The example, one of the formulas that was created by Solomon was later taken up by a man named Paracelsus, who about 500 years ago used chemotherapy to heal.